One thing that we need to understand, all of us need to understand, South Africa is still trapped on its disintegration, particularly on tribal lines. Particularly on tribal lines. Here, when you take out Zuma, you must know that you have already pissed off AmaZulu. Don't think that you are going to massage them. The AmaZulu, they are like a different kind. They are not like any other tribe that you can see in South Africa. They are staunch traditionalists. You take one of them away, they take everyone out. Mm. They are not going to say, no, it's Zuma, it's not AmaZulu. They view it in that narrative. Hence, in 2007, when the ANC was going to a conference, they were saying, no, even if you talk about you can grow economy or all these things, but now it's time to change sides. Which means that you must change, you know, like you must change tribe form of who is leading the country. Mm. They come from Xhosa. Nelson Mandela comes from Xhosa. And the beauty and the beautiful thing
also that will be
did, positive to itself, mm-hmm. but negative to us, it was that it maintained its structural form. Yes, we can say in a rhetorical form that apartheid is gone, but apartheid was
never it changed face.
Apartheid, it's still leading.
Apartheid, it was about the discrimination, it was about the segregation. And it was able to segregate people.
Yeah.
When you go to Mitchell's Plain, you know that you're going to meet colored people. When you go to Khayelitsha, you know that you're going to meet Xhosa people.
When I go
when you are in Soweto, when you go to Shawela,
expect the segregation police.
When you are in Soweto, when you go to Shawela, you know that you're going to meet Amapedi or Amavenda. Between the parties, the tribes of Limpopo, basically. When you go in certain parts of Soweto, you know that you're going to meet certain kind of people. So what we need to understand before we continue to destroy ourselves, apartheid made a point that it exists structurally, not that, not by a matter of rhetoric. Structurally, it means that apartheid will continue to exist post its term of, in fact, post its expiry date. Apartheid exists even today.
Sure.
Apartheid exists. When you go to Constantia, you know that it is likely possible that this place is a white man's place. And you can meet a black person. We cannot run away from that fact. You can meet a black person, but you know that it's a black person inside a white space. But Constantia came space is just a white space. When you go to certain sectors within the society of South Africa, you know that you're going to meet a certain kind. What I'm trying to expose is that here we are in a deep problem. White people want to then emerge this demon within the African fiasco. And the African fiasco has never been able to properly deal with the demon, which is called tribalism, entirely. Because the tribalism, we cannot deal with the tribalism outside the framework of local consciousness and Pan-Africanism. For as long as we still have got these 11 official languages, it is part of a tribal pushing, tribalism.
What you're saying is that Africa should have one,
so,
should have one language. That's what you're saying.
Yes, at some point we need to have one language. We need to have one language, but the problem now is not about one language now. It's the people understanding who they are in the current form. And the current format of people understanding who they are, they understand themselves.
Commander proper.
As Umzulu, as they understand themselves as Umxhosa, as Umzulu, as Umtswana. And the dangerous thing about pushing Zuma out, I need to speak about this Zuma question. The problem now about pushing Zuma out, you are like mobilizing. What happened in 1993, 1992, when AmaZulu were mobilizing themselves, besizwa ngoba bangamabutho. It's what you are actually pushing, because I'm telling you, AmaZulu are going to retaliate. And they are going to retaliate in a way that is not even, you cannot even comprehend yourself. You cannot even imagine the way they are going to retaliate. And the dangerous thing is that it will be black against black violence. Because the people who are pushing for Zuma to be out, it's also come in the form of blackface. For example, Umalem. For example, for Uland, what you call Ramaphosa. And this thing is very sinister, because It is the very same people who are saying that Zuma has got no charges. And Zuma is not like charge from new charges. The East is the very same charges that they were saying that
there are false charges.
Yo! Unless if they can convince me and say that no, it's new charges and all these things. They can come with the rhetoric of the state capture and all these things. But why don't we go to the state capture report? And the state capture report cannot only speak prior 1994. In fact, after 1994, they must be, if we are going to speak about state capture, we must be able to speak from 1652, when the white invaders came into our shores and showed their sinister motives.